Good morning, America, wherever you are in this big world. This is Dr. Cherry. And reminding you, we are still under this SOS to the world, deadly plutonic windows. And if you check the news, a lot of people did not make it. This window is still operational. Click on the link on the video that I did yesterday to read all the details. And most importantly, let's start with the good news. Something happened to me. You know, when the moon is in negative aspect to Pluto or during this specific SOS of the World Deadly Window, people get a wake-up call. People get to hear the truth. People get to really checked up with the reality of what's really, really going on. And I got my wake-up call. So we're going to discuss this in a minute. Just by looking at the title of this newsletter, you know that's going to be an interesting one. Good news. Here it is. My camera. Very expensive little toy. Close to $1,000. But it's going to do the job. Now you're going to tell me, why did I invest in this marvelous piece of equipment? I invest in it because what happened to me? What happened to me? It's so critical. It's so important. So let me give you the details. Okay, the title of this newsletter is Contacting the Desert. So obviously it has to do with contacting the desert. UFO science and the seacoast. Yes, Dr. Cherry, you cannot expect less than the undiluted truth with me because my work is designed to help everybody, friends and foes. All right, it is now confirmed after a quite a long discussion with my good friend Victoria yesterday. It's now confirmed I will not speak at the May 2020 Contact in the Desert UFO Conference. Why? Well, I have been lumped with a mass of people who could never differentiate reality from fiction and in the process have injured the good image and seriousness of those scientifically oriented UFO researchers that have been invited instead of me. All right, now, understand that I am not mad. And I do support, incidentally, I do support my good friend Victoria's decision. And now you have to read the details to why some of these people who have been hijacked by the reptilians, most of all those who are born Neptunian, which means they have an extraordinary imagination, and they applied to this imagination and deception and become UFO speakers. The next thing you know is people who have a much more rational, practical UCI, unique celestial identity or their cosmic design, have a problem delegating, dealing, understanding, and relating to these people, and for good reasons. Believe me. Since I have been myself in the UFO world, since 1995, after my first radio show on Art Bell, I have met dozens and dozens of those so-called UFO speakers. So it is not surprising that Victoria is doing what she does best as a Virgo born in September, Libra on the cusp, cleaning. It's her business. It's her decision. And I do endorse and support her decision, even if that means in the name of misinformation, because of a lack of information or investigation, name it, I've been dumped. Well, the good news is, I still have a big, huge voice, okay? And I'm still going to be speaking at a lot of UFO conferences in the future. In fact, I have one UFO conference coming up very, very, very soon. And you really, really should come up with us at the Snowfest Beer Lake UFO Conference. So that's going to be on January 24th, 25th, 26th. And believe me, my friends, once you watch that slideshow, you will really, really understand what's going on with the reptilians turning this world into a scientific bag. But the idea is to make all of us so practical, so rational, so agnostic, so critical, so that losing the essence of the spirit, we are not delegating the subtle mechanism, the subtle phenomenal, the subtle psychical phenomenon, which is cursing thousands upon the thousands of human beings on planet Earth. Believe me, my information are totally mind-boggling. They are both very rational, very practical, because I am a different type of scientist, UFO investigator, with the only difference, of course, unlike these new crowds who talk about UFOs, they've never seen a UFOs, or, you know, let alone talk to an extraterrestrial. So they have the right to be skeptical. They don't know me. They never investigated my predictions or my UFO predictive legacy, even when it's on coast to coast, giving you very specific date for earthquakes or telling you that the world's going to go in fire and now we're going to lose a hell of a lot of wildlife. A week later, you know, millions of animal perishes in the fire in Australia. Cannot make these things up, my friend. It is real. It is there. It is Dr. Cherry. So, again, make sure to read that newsletter, because this is a very, very important, critical newsletter that literally propulsed me to buy this and reverse the damage to the U.S. Department of Education, to the infected religious and scientific matrix, which are very wealthy, very well organized, and indoctrinate our children not to trust astrology, not to believe in astrology, to dismiss astrology, and to, of course, get acquainted to the world of UFOs on a more practical, rational, scientific way. My friend, it is all about a psychical phenomenon. Don't look for UFOs. They are already there in you, in your head, and you are not cosmic conscious and you're not necessarily aware of it. And this is why there is Dr. Cherry. This is why they are, and there are going to be a hell of a lot of UFO conferences and me showing my UFO slideshow and waking you up to the reality, to what's really going on out there outside of the limited five rational senses that are cursing our scientific community. So here we are, my friends. this energy is still plutonic. It's time for a wake-up call, okay? And I'm going to give you a wake-up call once you read and assimilate this newsletter. Until then, remember, losing a friend or a family member means also losing a wish. And this is why I totally understand. I'm too smart to be pissed off at my friend Victoria. I'm too smart. I know too much. I understand exactly where she's coming from. And I know she's a very smart lady. And maybe by reading this newsletter, she will assimilate my mission, my message a little bit better. Meantime, I do support and I understand the cleansing process, because all those UFO lunatic Neptunians are not doing a favor to the world of ufology. And it's time to really make a difference between divine cosmic information and pure imagination. The cleansing process has started with Victoria, and I hope it continues with other UFO conferences out there. So, meantime, there are real people. Real people that have been touched by the divine. And I am one of those. And I'm not saying this on an egotistic way, because it's real. It's me. And I prove it. My UFO predictive legacy is real. My mission is real. So until then, those who are ready and able to accept, to assimilate, and realize this subtle psychical cosmic phenomenon, those are the ones who are going to ask a little bit more than what scientists can offer you. Because the very fact that they are rational and they are practical dictate that a magnet will attract a piece of wood. It's pretty much obvious that if you do not, if you have not the tools, if you're not born with the tools, with the gift, you could never, never not only attract UFOs, but able to enter the archetypal realm of supracosmic consciousness and describe and explain God cosmic design and the part those entities, those UFOs, those ETs are playing in it. It is serious. It is very serious. And I'm very serious. All right, my friend. So again, share my messages. Hey, Dr. Turi, you're a crazy wacko. You're a crazy sicko. You know, but we like you. So click yes, you like me, and join my YouTube channel, which is incidentally growing pretty fast. I do have a bunch of radio shows. Click on those radio shows so you can hear a little bit more and join us. Okay, I'm going to be at Contact in the Desert because I have served a lot of people last year, and those people are expecting me there. Of course, they're going to be deceived because I won't speak. But hey, you know what? Life is a constant process of magical changes. I will be there, and I will be taking care of all of you. So join us at Contact in the Desert, and join me very, very soon. Join me at that UFO conference at the UFO Alien Snowfest Beer Bear Lake on January 24th, 25th, and 26th. And I promise you, once you've watched my UFO slideshow, you'll understand Dr. Turi a little bit better. Until then, my friend, make it a wonderful, fantastic day. And be careful what you do. Be careful what you see, what you say, where you go. Because it's time currently for another couple of days for serious wake-up calls. All right. Take it easy. See you again sometime. Bye-bye.